Right. Some people think I'm anti-ATUs. I'm not anti-ATUs. I just think that sometimes we are sold stuff that we don't need. All right. We do, well, potentially we need something, but let me take you through my thinking. So, from the 40 meter band upwards, most sections of the bands that we operate in, like a dipole or a vertical, will have enough bandwidth to be able to do, let's say, take the 40 meter band. So, let's take the 20 meter band. So, 20 meter band is, by the way, ignore my purple nail polish. They were having fun as a family a minute ago. And apparently, I've got to let it dry and then we can take it off. I don't know much about nail varnish, okay? That's not the purpose of this video. So, let's take the 20 meter band. It's a 14.0 to 14.3. Now, I don't know what percentage increase that is. All right, it looks about 2% to me, give or take. But anyway, I'm just saying, even a, oh no, three, that's 50, 350. Okay, so it's the whole band is 350 small k, big H, little z or z, 350 kilohertz. Now, a straight vertical, for instance, if that's 14, that's 14.35. And we've got an SWR of, let's say, 3 here, 2 there, 1 and 0. You will find that the SWR will be, it's actually a bit steeper at the end there. But you will cover the whole of, at about 2 to 1, SWR, you'll cover the whole of 20 metres. And that will be a dipole or a vertical, for instance. The same at all the other bands, apart from the 10 metre band, which, depending on part of the country, but that can go from 28 all the way to 29.7 or something. That is quite a lot in terms of megahertz, but in terms of percentage of the wavelength, it's not as much as the next problem, which is where you might need an ATU for the 80 meter band, or in America, is called a 80 and a 75 meter band, because in the UK we can go from 3.5, which is the CW end, to 3.8. There we are. Now that is a lot. It's 300 kilohertz. I was trying to make that small. 300 kilohertz, but as a percentage, it's a lot. Okay. So you'll find that a straight vertical or a dipole will give you somewhere between 100 and 200 kilohertz of that, just depending on a number of factors. So you'd be lucky to go from 3.65 to 3.8. Your average Joe antenna, bit of wire, right? I mean, and that's stretching it at sort of 2 to 1 SWR. As if you want to go lower, all the way down to the proper part of the band, the CW end of the band, then you'll have to engage some sort of tuning unit just to take the mismatch away between the coax and the radio. Now, this isn't some sort of tuners are bad, balanced feeders are good, blah, blah, blah. I'm just saying that your average Joe's got a piece of coax into the backyard, back garden, he's going to have a problem with that. If he ever gets on 160, the problem becomes even more serious. Is as a percentage of the band from one end to the other becomes even tighter. All right. It basically doubles every time you go up, or it halves every time you go down, basically. So when do you need an ATU? If you're serious about 80 meters. Now, I've got an ATU, but I don't run it because my antenna, I mean, it's just a vertical. It's got a coil in it. And I go from about, 3.68 to about 3.78 at 2 to 1 at SWR between the two. So I'm at about 3.74 is roughly my sweet spot, you see. So I don't need an ATU for that. But if I wanted to do FT, because that's SSB portion of the band, if I wanted FT8, which is down below 3.6, I seem to remember, then my SWR is going to be 3-4 to 1. By the way, I've looked at the chart here, right? I mean, this happens to be, I just did, I'll show you. I just did a search, power loss SWR chart. There's plenty of people that have copied this from me, and he hasn't invented this, he's copied it from somewhere else. So if we look at 3-1 SWR, I'm getting 25% loss, okay? So 75% of my power is going out the door. At 6-1, right, which is actually quite a big SWR, I'm half my power is going out the door. All right, half my power is definitely going out the door. Well, that's not bad. I mean, I've got a 200 watt radio or the 60 meter band, and I haven't got an antenna tuned for that. I happen to know my SWR is about 6-1. Well, that's all right. I could run 200 watts. I'm only allowed, I think I'm only allowed 100 watts at the other end anyway. 6-1 SWR, I engage the ATU button, and most modern radios will go up to about a 10-1 SWR. I don't know, my TS2000 doesn't, I think the TS590's got a problem with that. But yeah, there's some loss on the line, but it's no big deal. You still get out, you'll still receive, okay? That's the point. So before you go out buying ATU matching units and everything else, I think the biggest question is, well, what sort of antenna I want to run? You know, a fan dipole will give you a perfect match to coax on 40, 20, 15 and 10, for instance. Now, I'm not selling you my DX Commander product, but, you know, I mean, I designed that because I didn't like ATUs. And it's not like I didn't like them. I didn't want the extra kit to take away my holiday. And I didn't want the extra cost. So I designed an antenna that I didn't need any of that with. Just, well, give me a match on every band. Just give me 1-1 SWR, thereabouts. 1.5-1 SWR. 1.5 SWR. Oh, big deal. I'm losing 4 watts out of every 100. There we are. I've waffled enough. It's just food for thought. Before you go and buy an ATU, think to yourself, well, maybe I could just change the antenna. Maybe I can put another bit of wire in. Maybe I can invest in a nice piece of coax and just drive my ATU button on the radio. Because unless you're running a transistor amplifier, you shouldn't actually need an ATU. Let's say you've got a modern radio. There's an ATU button, and that will take out most of this. It'll still let you operate. And if you find, actually, I'm spending most of my time on FT8 at 80 meters, well, tune the antenna down there. And for SSB, hit the ATU button. There we go. Right, if you think this is of value to other people, then giving a thumbs up, commenting, or subscribing will tell YouTube, oh, Fred in Texas found this valuable. Or I know someone else who watches similar stuff to this. I'm going to recommend it to him. That's the only reason that people actually ask you to hit the thumbs up, comment, or subscribe. It helps other people. I mean, it helps me as well. It just gives me a bit more coverage. And why not? Have a jolly good day. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.